I say we do it. He's a pedophile.
No, he's not.
He just told us he was.
He has never acted on his urges, and he's asking us to do something to ensure he never does. He is a decent person.
I'm confused. What do you want to do with him?
Treat him like a patient with a diagnosis. Put him on antidepressants, refer him to a urologist, give him a psych eval. Let the experts determine if he should have a castration.
Psych eval? Antidepressants? When we refer people for counseling, how often do they get cured?
I am looking to help him manage.
And if they don't get cured, what happens? They get more depressed, can't cope, quit jobs, maybe kill themselves? All bad, but not rape a child bad.
So what are you going to do?
We can't ethically remove healthy organs for crime prevention. We don't amputate a kleptomaniac's hands to prevent them from stealing.
A hands have many purposes. The balls of a pedophile have but one.
Set up his referrals and patch him up.
What we're doing is cruel.
I'm open to all options, Dr. Brown. I'm gonna have to ask you to give us some privacy.
Really? You want to throw the president of the hospital out of a medical discussion?
You're infringing on my autonomy and inhibiting the free flow of ideas, both of which affect my ability to deliver the best patient care. Dr. Melendez?
Effects of low testosterone on cardiovascular function and sepsis?
Possible acute vascular response, circulatory collapse.
And what about on DIC?
Increased risk of clots and stroke.
George's body can't tolerate any loss of testosterone right now. We want to save his life. We have to save his testicles.
Sutures.